Hey guys, welcome back to the European Challenger Series. It's time for the second game between H2K Gaming and SK Gaming Prime, with a shot at competing for an LCS berth on the line. Now, H2K does lead the series 1-0, and they've looked pretty good so far.
Oh yeah, H2K... Yeah, that happened. H2K's team fight was superior to SKP, and they fought a lot. And what ended up happening was it was a pick comp versus a team fight comp, and the team fight comp won. And then they base raced each other at the end. Just basically, SK Gaming Prime threw down the cards and said, yep, we're going to try this, and it didn't come up big at all.
Yeah. I understand the choice to go for it just because they were far behind. When a team is pushing his 5 with a Baron buff, good luck, right? They don't even have very good wave clear. It's like they got Twitch ulti and Aurelia R, right? Like there's not a lot of good ways to defend. So I understand the choice to say, let's just be desperate and try. Yes, it didn't pay off. Honestly, I'm not sure if there are many plays left, so I'm not like going to flame them for the base race attempt. But yeah, to let it get that far, definitely mistakes by SK Prime. We'll see if they can turn that one back around here. H2K, just over and over again, they seem like a very solid team who's done their homework. Their level one was awesome. They came down to the bottom lane in time to contest Dragon or a push, whichever it was going to be, and they were there to defend. The fact that they got Odwamna a bunch of farm, whereas they really held down Smitty, perfect play, right? Like, H2K strategically got the first 50 minutes down pat. They got caught a little bit too much, and they kind of tossed the game away for a short time, but they came back and turned it around.
Yeah, and a big thing here is, I'm just going to say it flat out, it's easier to play a team fight comp than it is a pick comp. You have to be more organized in a different manner.
Yeah.
You have to split correctly. You have to rotate correctly. Team fight compositions, you're like, all right, group is 5,
yeah,
and fight them.
Yes.
Our abilities are better and more AoE oriented.
Yeah. The only time a team fight comp is hard is when the opposing team has a stronger split pusher.
Yes.
If you're like, dude, Odwamna can't hold up to Smitty, then it's like, okay, you need to know when to pull him down and sacrifice the top lane power. The fact that Odwamna could push him out and then just show makes it completely easy. So they, yeah, I completely agree with you. H2K set themselves up for success very well. Now we're going to see what else these guys can do. Now, SK Prime banning out the two junglers that were played in the last game. Kha'Zix still removed by H2K here. So now we're going to see, how good is Trashy's champion pool? This tells me the Elise pick that was so early was a steal to try to put Trashy in something bad that he wasn't good at. Wasn't the case. Eve's still good. So more bans coming through. H2K, what can they pinch from the jungle? Or SKP, what can they pinch from the jungle?
Okay, here's the thing is, we always talk about how there's those top 4 junglers with Lee Sin, Evelynn, Elise, and Kha'Zix. They're all off the table right now. Thing is, Trashy, very, very potent Wukong player.
Yeah, yeah.
He has played Wukong since the beginning of the Challenger scene, and he wrecked with that champion. I remember his objective control and his teamfight prowess. That's exactly what H2K played last time, was a teamfight-oriented composition. If they go for a Wukong, they're going to go straight for that again.
Absolutely. He'll have a little bit less early playmaking, but certainly I want to see what this ends up being. Of course, Jax has been left up, so that goes through Twitch. Available if they want it, plus a support to peel back for him, or it's like, is Vi or Nocturne or Jarvan like this really big deal where you've got to grab?
Yeah, see, that's the thing too, is he's been playing a lot more Jarvan recently than Wukong, because there were nerfs to Wukong's Q. He's not as great of an early game jungler.
Sure.
Jarvan, had this conversation with you before, and since I love Jarvan from season three, he's very powerful right now. In 4.9, he's even more potent because of the lack of experience in the jungle in comparison to before. Right now, he's still really good. If they pick an Orianna in synergy with that, then it's a huge win for them, because they will be able to pick the fights that they want, jump in, use Cataclysm, just get everybody into that fight with the Shockwave and the Dissonance. But they're not going to go for it just yet, is what it looks like. I would be very surprised to see this Ashe go through, and that's much more likely, yes.
So they go for the cream of the crop for the bottom lane here. They want to bully this one out. Yarnan did have a really rough time on Sivir last game, and so learning from that lesson, picks up pretty much the premier lane bully, and with all the options available, Lucian Thresh.
Yes, and actually, we should have talked about what was locked in. We see the Jax, and you said that the best thing against a teamfight composition is a strong split pusher,
yeah,
bringing that to the table. They do that immediately with Jax. They conjunction out with the Kayle, give him the invulnerability, make him an unstoppable force, but Smitty loves playing those scaling junglers, but
yeah.
Trashy was really adept at keeping Smitty down all last game.
Yeah.
He got almost no farm in the early game, and then he ended up, I think, 0-4 by the end of it.
Yeah, had a really rough start to it. So more changes being made as well on top of the Jax. A Kayle does come through, which is, I want to say a better laner than LeBlanc. Now, early game, actually, Watt to Fox had fallen behind Fabivan. In the 1v1, he was like 30 CS down or so, and that's a pretty substantial mark. So the Jarvan actually does come through for SKP.
You made me think of it.
Yep.
Just so it covered through. Over, it's like, that's a good jungler.
Yeah.
There was a jungle tier list that came out, and Crumbs, in conjunction with another person, was saying, you know what? Jarvan's about top 4, top 5 jungler currently. You know, above Evelynn is what they were saying. I don't completely agree with that, but I think he's extremely strong right now in 4.9, 4.8 when we buffed his Marshall Cadence.
Yeah.
Does a lot of early game damage, a lot of upfront burst.
Yeah.
He can take somebody down very quickly. In longer fights, he's not as good as he used to be.
Yeah.
But in the early game, it's all about chunking somebody down, whether it's making them retreat or actually killing them. They're both great.
Yeah, and the test I want to see actually for the Jarvan is, when was he going to EQ to gank versus flash W to gank? Because once you force a flash, then you go for the knockup. It's so telegraphed you can flash out of that and you've got nothing left. So I want to see how that pans out. Immediately, Kayle gets to support a Twitch now down here for the AD carry pickup there. SK Prime's comp looks awesome and are really good at 5v5s, but H2K not going to change almost a thing about this. The only new champion here in this lineup is the Lucian instead of Sivir. And they will need a new jungler, but H2K is saying, worked last time. Keep it going.
It definitely worked last time. The coordination and getting on the back of Fabevin and the great positioning he had in conjunction with Odwamna just jumping in with the Dragon's Rage. The Dragon's Descent. Big thing here, though, is SK Prime. They're looking at a lot of multi-threat solo champions here. In conjunction with each other, they do work very well, but each one of them has the opportunity to split push. Like, no matter what, if one of them does well, they're going to start split pushing. They can even go for 1-3-1 effectively.
Oh, easily. Easily. And actually, they've got a nice little early game holdover there, Karma there, to help bully out the lane and kind of equalize the fact that Lucian, Thresh are such good laners. Not the best peel for Twitch, but they've got a Kayle anyway, so who cares? I like this team. I think SK Prime's champs, like, once again, very good. They just got to play it right.
Yeah, big thing here is they last picked the Vi. The reason they picked Orianna and Shyvana first was because the support for SK Prime had not come out. If it was a Morgana, he probably wouldn't have picked the Vi. Because Black Shield is very effective versus Assault and Battery. She basically locks herself up and puts herself in the middle of the team. Granted, that would work very well, because it's still going to just slap the ball onto her after the point and click of Assault and Battery. This is very easy for Fabevin. He's going to have the easiest Orianna game of his life in terms of team fighting. He's just like, as long as Trashy sets me up correctly, or Odwamna, he has multiple options.
True.
As long as somebody gets in there, it's going to be a good shockwave.
This is going to be kind of interesting then. I want to see how these comps play out, because they'll both look for interesting 5v5s. Now, you mentioned Fabivan having one of the easiest Orianna games of his life. The laning, however, much less so. Jarvan jungle can pretty much EQ you from the brush in the first place. Kayle's got a point and click slow. Like, that's going to be a difficult lane matchup for him. He won it last time, but he won that without much pressure from the opposition. If there's more this time around, maybe that one flips. And, I mean, a lot of this game could change just based on the fact of who's playing well individually right now, who's getting in on these fights. And you know, getting the ganks off, getting the early lead, and then because the comps play similarly, they can just bash heads, and if you have the gold lead, you'll win.
Yeah, exactly. And I feel like SK's composition has more options available to it. They're good at team fights. H2K has a little bit better team fight, but at the same time, they're much better at split pushing on the side of SKP. Mm-hmm. They can go for a 1-3-1, and they'll be perfectly fine with that, and they'll get at least one, maybe two turrets off of it. And the fact that they have the Karma here can do a little bit of zone control for a disengage, because there's so much engagement here on H2K. They're going to be coming straight into the team.
Well, here we go. SK Prime making their way around.
Gilius already with the sweeper very early on. They might go for an invade here. They'll look for the ward.
The funny thing about putting a ward down in the brush you see right there, the little river brush, if you put it down early, it'll time out before any meaningful invade comes up. So you don't really want to ward that early, but it will watch if, like, your opponent's ward or if your opponents are doing something like an early invade for ward coverage.
Ooh. Wanda Fox already has his E leveled up. So
interesting.
He's ready to go straight for. He's not going to get a Reckoning. He's going to go straight for the Righteous Fury. Yep.
That trinket ward does get spotted.
So they have multiple options here. As soon as it hits the correct mark, there you go. It's going to go ahead, get rid of it. It's going to signal to H2K to group up on this side, because that's where the Jarvan is.
And they are all there. So 5-on-5, all nearby. Trinket wards, one is left open.
I don't know what SK Prime's plan is right now. Because if they invade late, they're going to be seen. They already gave away the fact that they swept the ward out. And that Jarvan is on the blue side of the jungle.
We're going to have 2-on-2 lanes. They're both top.
Yeah, they're both going to go ahead and top each other. Yeah, they're going to go for a late invade now. And
well,
they see it.
This is tricky.
They have multiple options here. They can loop all the way around, or they can just go for the blue, and then they have more information for H2K.
Yes.
So they can actually get SK Prime on the retreat.
Maybe, but Zyze and Zyatan actually going to make their way around, and actually they're going to walk right into Yharnam. And I wonder if Jarvan's going to get caught out on this one. They can, of course... I mean, they already knew from the walking, but they can also infer the fact that the red buff's definitely been grabbed at this point because of where the dual lane came in from. And look at this.
They see Gilius there, but there's everybody else. Trashy, not level 2, Gilius is. So he can actually have the EQ combo straight out of the fight.
Okay, so nothing picked up actually by either side. Then just kind of trading vision back and forth. Smitty's going to counter jungle this Wraith camp and come join Gilius now by the mid lane. Fibivin's going to be safe on this one, and looks like we will continue our regular buff starts there as they trade sides in the map. And Trashy,
I don't know if I'd say regular. Gilius is going for the blue. He's going for all of the enemy jungle here.
This is a really risky play, but honestly,
no one's
punishing it at all.
It's really good. They don't have vision of it. They have no idea it's being done. Trashy, he was only level 1 after the buff start. He did not get level 2 off of it, whereas Gilius did. So Gilius had the EQ combo available to him. Also, Trashy had to clear another camp. So even if Gilius ran into Trashy there, it would have been a level 1 to level 2.
Drama's got to be careful. Now he's going to know that both those buffs were taken, so the only buff left on the map is that bottom lane red buff. Trashy should know this, but he knows, you know what? I can't get there. I'm just going to grab the wolf camp.
It doesn't have the vault breaker. Can't get over walls. He's going for the early clear. But man, he is so behind right now, and I don't know if he knows it.
He's got to. The fact that he saw double buff on Gilius.
Yeah, that's right. He went down bottom, showed himself. Also, another thing, too, is that Trashy... if he was doing his blue and Gilius showed up, Gilius would have an advantage because Trashy didn't have a point in Vault Breaker,
absolutely,
couldn't get away. Also, red buff was on Gilius, so he has more dueling potential in the early game.
And there's the downside occasionally of sharing XP with your top laner and jungler.
Yep.
Because once in a while, you have to actually fight for that second buff, and in that case, that's how it happened. And the buff's from the same side of the map. So how it can go down. Gilius not going to find his way in just yet. He's still pinging around.
Big thing, though, is that now that he knows he has the experience advantage, he can go for a gank, knows he won't be behind.
He can't gank this.
Also, he can go for a counter jungle.
Yes,
and he would be perfectly fine.
That's the better option right there. He can take the wolves down. He can. He actually probably could have recontested the Wraith camp. Thing is, he saw the Vi clear the Wraith camp.
Yep.
And so he could actually pretty easily tell Trashy's movements from there and actually maybe catch him back in the jungle. Not going to be the case. He's going to look for the wave on the backside, though, of this bottom lane. Maybe.
Yep. Finally, level 3 here for Trashy. Gilius just completely counter-jungling Trashy. Trashy's going to have almost no option on the Vi except to go for a gank because he can't try to counter the counter-jungle because he'll end up losing. And the fact that if he goes into Gilius' jungle, Gilius is about to just put himself back in there and start farming his own. So Trashy's going to be picking up scraps.
Ooh, hook though on a Zyatan. Good damage. Nice two-man play. Ignite is on Zyatan.
Forced
away.
Lantern.
But look at that lantern. The jump forward. One more attack will do it. There's
back.
The W. The flash auto attack picks up the kill. Now Zyze in a 1v2. I don't think he can stay. Good play. This is not good for the Twitch. One more attack would do it. Already flashes down, but he survives with the potion regen. But look at that. H2K. They pick up an early duo lane, and it pays off.
AOD's hooks all last game were on point. This game coming up big as well. I'm very surprised that SKP didn't actually go for the Morgana and Champion Select because they'd already seen the Thresh come out. It would have been a very good pickup for them, but also at the same time, it would have kept Twitch safe, and it would have stopped a Vi pick.
Absolutely would have. So great stuff now. H2K doing awesome things. SK Prime going to try to keep that Twitch catching up, but he's down 8 CS right now. They're going to have to wait on that one for a while. Wat de Fox is doing well in his mid lane, up 6 minions over Febiven. Udomina versus Smitty right now actually holding equal as well. So it's just the duo lane that's really paying off right there. And Gilius, equal level right now to Trashy, hasn't held him down too much aside from the fact that Trashy's only picking up scraps.
Yeah, didn't clear it. Trashy does have 21 CS, but
they're mostly raids.
Mostly tiny little things that he's had to clean up. Gilius sitting at 8, but he's sitting at a big chunk of 8. He's sitting top. Just camping.
Yeah, well, he's out of range of what a trinket ward would be. In fact, he will see that AOD is going to ward this.
Or walk through it.
Okay.
Oh, now he knows he's not behind him. He's going to flank them.
No? He knows he's not seen. He's going to get this flank on. Now, can they turn this one around, though? There's no summoners up at all for H2K, except for a heal. Oh, Hook comes in, but here they go. AOD has no way out.
Oh!
Nice play is going to stop the knockup, but is it going to be enough damage? I don't think he's going to survive, and he doesn't. Flash in. Trashy, Odwamna are there, and Smitty's going to go down. Nice gank at the bottom lane. Well forced.
And Trashy's now actually got a level advantage over Gilius because he just reserved himself to farming, picking up as much as he could. Gilius spent a lot of time trying to rebalance the lane because of the solo kill up top.
Mm-hmm.
Or the non-jungle involved kill top.
Gilius has spent a lot of time trying to set things up, and he's fallen behind on XP because of it, whereas Trashy's ganks have been rather swift. Yarnin! Ooh, doesn't steal it.
It comes straight in here. It looked like an advantage for Smitty. They both hit the six, but Trashy comes in just a tip the tables in Odwamna's favor.
A good flash into the Vault Breaker afterwards. All this pretty happy. So H2K, though, they are equal in gold right now. These teams are tied, basically, because look at this. Zyze has now gotten ahead of Yearnin in minion kills. This blue buff going to be going over rather easily to Watt to Fox. Gilius got to be a bit careful. Hurry up.
Easily.
Hurry up, Kale.
Easily.
Hurry up, Kale. Ooh, all right, he's fine. Level 5, he's good.
He said easily, and I was like, that's the hardest blue buff I've ever seen. Oh, my lord.
Whatever, he didn't die.
Yeah, close, because he hasn't backed yet.
Yeah, true.
Whereas Trashy has backed twice. Mm. He backed and got the Spirit Stone, and now he has the two long swords. Now they're just even in their builds currently, and he's coming back up top. Trashy already 6.
Wow, that is a lot of experience. So we're going to see what's gonna pay off too much. Lantern
there
grab.
It is.
Here's the attempt for... Nope, just the ulti right away on his
Zyze
hand. The Vault Breaker as well if he wants it. There we go. Kill picked up by Yearnin, and good dodge by Zyze. But the level 6 Vi gank... nice and secure.
The fact that he had Thresh means that he can go ahead, take the Lantern to close the distance, not use the Vault Breaker, use the Salt and Battery, and the Salt and Battery will put you on the opposite end of the person.
Mm-hmm.
So you just Vault Breaker them for like a quarter second, just tap the button, and it knocks them into your team.
Uh-oh, and Gilius.
Nope, that's not up for another 3 or 4 minutes at this point.
It was cleared around 6 minutes, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
6 minutes is when Vi came in. Trashy cleared that one out. Gilius, unfortunately, missing all the wards. They walked by a pink ward, didn't see it. Swept the wrong brush. That tri-brush ward's there. So plenty of vision to keep H2K safe on that side of the map.
Trashy, he's repeat ganking top lane right now. They see him.
Wow. Oh, that's going to reveal him.
Yeah.
That particle shows.
You see the excessive force through the wall,
especially
just like you see Nocturne.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And there he even pulls the
ward will help.
Yeah. The one thing is actually that, that was close. The white actually showed that Twitch was down there because it aggroed upwards instead of over to the
And they just got knowledge that there's a ward in there because the minions followed Trashy all the way through. Minions will not follow you through a bush unless there's a ward in there. Pro tips.
Pro tips.
This entire game, I'm like, pro tips. Junglers that I play all the time. Jarvan, you want to cue it before you hit it with your passive because your passive physical damage and your Q is armor shred.
He just walked by a ward again.
Oh.
It got pinged.
He's cool with it, though. He's like, he wanted to ward further up to see if somebody would come stop him from getting the ping.
Yeah, and then he flag tosses to watch the other where you didn't.
Yep. Keep yourself covered.
Good play, then. All right, Gilius. Making it happen. Level 6 now on Jarvan. Now, Shyvana has a way out of the Jarvan ulti, though.
Mm-hmm.
How well can they play this one? The EQ, if you play it really well, you can actually stuff the Dragon's Ascent with an EQ.
They're grouped around the dragon. There haven't been any big team fight moves just yet. It's 10 minutes in. People have just been trying to crawl back into the game since the early. But Trashy is now ahead. And the ganks top are putting just a completely different lane down. What ended up happening is Trashy noticed that last game Zyze was trying to carry. Just keep ganking that lane. Keep getting as much denial of CS as you possibly can. And try to delay the power spikes of Twitch, because it worked last game a bit. Both junglers down bottom, though. Neither of them have information on this, though.
This is going to be all kinds of interesting, then. 2-on-2. Lanes are pretty equal, except Odwamna has a bunch of tank stat that Smitty does not have.
Who's going to show first, though?
So Odwamna baits the fight, and here they go for the battle. And there comes Vi, but here comes Jarvan. The battle's afoot. This dodge going to come in. Nice assault and battery, though, just explodes, and Smitty's going to go down. Now Jarvan in the 1v2, forced to flash away.
Trashy
Q. Can he juke it? He cannot. Big damage and a double kill.
here for Trash, the new jungler of the team, making it big right here. Zai's now hooked up as well by AOD, the new support. The Q comes out. One more auto attack. One more for the kill. Flay's going to miss, but the summoner heal, Yurnin, he wants
this
one.
He's got 1 second on his E.
Oh, he doesn't quite find it, but Walk the Fox finds the kill onto Febavin.
He's got the heal. Away.
Odwam to the W's up soon.
The Q.
The slow comes out, and Walk the Fox makes it happen. Trashy does not have a way, and his flash was almost back up.
No burnout available there. So close. Febavin ends up going down to Walk the Fox.
A lot of great plays with these guys. You're seeing the individual skill plenty high on all sides.
All across the board. But H2K end up with a big gold lead after that, about 3,000. And Walk the Fox just turns the table here on Febavin with the heal. Oh, Odwamnet.
He turned.
Turned out of the bush. And that gave enough time to Walk the Fox to go ahead and just run away and get his cooldowns back.
No, cooldowns just weren't quite up for anyone else either. Febavin not quite able to get the damage down. Smitty once again in the battle against Odwamnet. He's keeping the levels up, to be fair, and keeping up at CS despite the two deaths. Smitty is playing quite nicely, even with all the intervention. So,
yeah, and a big part of this gold lead, too, is that the top lane turret ended up going down around the same time. But this leaves Zai's to go ahead and just try and free farm. But that also frees up the bottom lane of H2K, which are going to go straight for the dragon.
It's a great play on all sides now. H2K continuing to jump his gold lead higher, up about 3,500 after this goes down. You're going to see 20.3 to 16.9. Quick recall from Trashy. Already has the Lizard Elder, Zaitan, and Zai's kind of capitalizing on the fact that the team is bot lane. They would be able to answer this turret back. So it looks like this gold lead will be a little bit closer than it was before, as long as they stay for this.
So Trashy, despite getting a one buff start, is now two levels up over Gilius, and he's hit that level 9 power spike for Vi, where you can get two Vault Breakers off in a single gank, which is huge. When he was level 8, he just barely got the second one off to get the second kill on Gilius down bottom. Now that he's 9, it's no problem at all.
Well, it's going to be a big threat then. SK Prime's got to watch out for these Vi ganks and see how well they can play around this. Red buff comes back up. H2K going to be able to grab that one very easily for themselves. Looks like no one's around to stop this one. Zai's, he stealths on top of a ward, so not going to find anyone.
Oh, hello.
Hello, Twitch.
Nice little chuckle for you, too.
Yeah.
He was happy to see you. He was happy to see you.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Who isn't? Not me.
Wow.
I'm always happy to see you.
That's good. You know.
Anyway.
I'm lukewarm.
Thought you were a freak. Why are you lukewarm? No. Anyway, going on. They're going to the bottom lane now. Zai, Smitty trying to make a pick here onto Odwamnet. They do have AOD off on the side for escape, and Trashy's here too.
Ooh, Odwamnet's got to be careful. He's going to get away with the Dragon Form, but Smitty's got to be careful. A lot of burst comes out. Trashy claims that
one.
Now Gilius hooked under the turret. Let's get away from this one. Looks like they will keep the turret safe. Plus
the second
kill.
Breaker.
Oh, the flash Q. Zai's got to be careful. No Flay's going to land. There's a distance hasting him up. Ward goes down to the wall. Zai's has nowhere to go. He goes down to Febavin. 8-2 in kills. Hook on
another.
A Zaitan. AOD. Make it happen. Trash going to tank. Turret aggro. Ignite is on. That is surely a kill as well. And H2K just making fights happen in the mid game.
Yeah, the big power spike for Vi is the level 9. He got 3 Vault Breakers off in that. Closes the distance, does a ton of damage, applies your W. It is huge. They get a turret off of it and multiple kills.
Beautiful stuff by these guys. Gilius forced to go back to his own jungle to grab the red. Thankfully, he doesn't get that stolen away, but there's really not much for SKP to do. Every time Smitty looks for a fight, someone's there to turn it around. Every single time. Trashy, and sometimes others, are there to stuff it in his face.
They're keeping the right people down this game. Walk the Fox has pretty much been on an island in the mid lane. Haven't seen too much in terms of roaming. He's up 40 CS right now.
He's destroying.
Yeah, he's destroying that lane. But Febavin saying, I'm just going to roam with my team because I just can't stay in this lane at the moment, which is the right move.
Yes, it is.
You can't stay in the lane. Go ahead and get your other lanes ahead, which Trashy's been doing an amazing job of. 2-0-5 right now. Coming up huge for his team, setting him up for success.
Wonderful stuff by these guys. And you're seeing H2K, again, right? They're playing the game properly. If there's a disadvantage, they play around it. If there's an advantage, they play around it even better. And it's been awesome to watch these guys.
Trashy, he's near top again. But here comes Gilius.
But he's going to land the stun on Dwamna. Ooh! Oh! Gets away. It hits the ulti just late enough.
He wants
well
to fight,
played.
Here comes Trashy.
Dragon ulti is going to be big. Here comes Trashy. You are right. 2-on-2. Flash away. Ooh, the... Yo!
Oh, the burnout!
The burnout makes it happen. Wow, Dwamna making it.
Dragon singed is pretty much what that
pretty
was.
Pretty much dragon singed. Two levels up, actually. Pretty.
Don't chase the Shyvana either.
Yeah. Well, yeah, again, when you're two levels up, it's going to be a lot of stats your opponents don't have. Rank 2 Jax ulti would have been enough to win that fight,
yes.
But Smitty was held down enough by those miraculous, awesome counter ganks by Trashy that matchup is snowballed. Even though Smitty was doing excellently in the 1v1, it's finally broken.
He's always done excellently in his 1v1s. Mm. He usually crushes the lane by about 90 CS we talked about.
Right.
He's going even with Odwamna in CS, which is huge. It really speaks to his playstyle. The fact that he likes to farm and likes to play those hyper carries, but he's 0-4. He has just been shut down. He goes aggressive at the right times, but the fact that Trashy is there at
yeah.
the right, at the even better times, he realizes what Smitty's going to do. He realizes when Smitty's going to go in, and they abuse that. The last two or three kills that have happened onto Smitty, it's because Trashy was there at the same time that Gilius was, and they read the movements.
That's just beautiful reading by these guys. So right now, we got to see how this game is going to progress, because SK Prime, they're at one item Twitch right now. He's got a ways to go. Though Yirnin without a Trinity Force done isn't too much more powerful despite his kill and CS lead. When he goes to shop, that might change a little bit. Top laners, you've still got a ways to go for Smitty, but you can, to some extent, rely on Watt to Fox to put massive damage down. There's not a lot of MR yet in the builds of H2K, and just maybe he can carry those fights.
And they're starting to work towards them.
Yeah, they're starting now.
Just now. See the Negatron Cloak for Dwamna. Trashy's going to go for Mercury Treads. Going to go ahead and get themselves a mid lane turret. Because they see down bottom, there are two members of SKP. Continuing to push it down. Also taking advantage of the jungle. Dragging up in 30 seconds. And the ward coverage here is superior for H2K in that area.
Yeah, they've played the timings exactly right. Mid lane went down, went to the top for the blue buff. Now they're going to go down for the dragon, 15 seconds till that comes up. These guys are ready for everything as it spawns around the map.
Keeping the timers. Oh, Zyze.
Play. Hook.
Oh!
Ooh. Flash play. Box gets flashed away from. Zyze burns heal though, and it breaks his stealth. That's not good. Down it goes. Nice ulti in from Trashy. And that means dragon.
Absolutely for them. They're going to pick this one up for themselves, make it even higher gold lead, around the 7,000 mark for H2K.
This game's just rough right now. 19 minutes
yeah.
in.
It's 7,000. Very, very rough right now for SKP. The gold all across the board in every lane, even the mid lane,
yep.
is in H2K's favor.
The global golden kills and assists he's gotten has made that one happen, so H2K... What are we going to say about them, right? They're definitely in command and lead right now.
Yeah, they're definitely one of the scariest challenger teams out there, the one with the target on their back that everybody's chasing after. Because they won last time. They took the entire thing. They got 3-0'd by Super Hot Crew, who are the top three team right now in the EULCS. So it's completely understandable.
Sure.
Because, I mean, five other people are losing to Super Hot Crew.
Yeah. But the cool thing is, like, H2K, they look better than the C9E that was at... The playoff tournament, right? Like, one of the big questions was, you know, these guys lost Ko, and you saw how weakly they played when Ko was gone. With Trashy, Trashy's doing awesome. Voidal's gone from the team. They grab AOD. Those two replacements are looking really, really good for this team.
Yeah, and Trashy,
great plays.
To sing his praises, ever since I saw him in the challenger scene, I really liked his jungling style because he does everything. He doesn't just gank. He will farm when he has to, and he will get the objectives and the control. We saw it here that he was down in levels at the start, and he immediately came back. He got level 6 over Gilius after only getting a 1 buff start and getting counter jungled. He completely came back on his own. Mm-hmm. And Trashy, in my opinion, was the best member of Reason Gaming based on KDA, based on the way he set his team up, and they ended up getting third place in one of the Challenger Series and getting fourth place in the playoffs, basically off of Trashy's back. H2K realized that, pick him up, and it's a great pickup for their team.
Yeah, this is a scary-looking team right here.
He plays very similar to Ko.
He does.
In terms of play style.
Very smart, very active.
He's not as aggressive in his ganks as Ko is, but he's very active, very present on the map. He will gank very frequently and very early, but he knows how to control the objectives. So that would be a very exciting matchup eventually. But right now, the thing is can SKP come back in this game? Right now, since the team comps are very similar, we talked about, they got to go for a pick. But it's so hard to pick against a Thresh.
Yep, exactly. You see that right there. They go for it. They land the slow, flag toss, and nothing.
Like, they can try to split push, but Smitty's not at the point that he can split push. What the Fox can get dueled right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's like, there's a lot of people who could do it. I was thinking about him, like, Odwamne might be able to come up once he completes his magic resistance item. But I don't think they would even go for it. Like, at that point, if Wata Fox is out of fight.
Oh, wow. Zyze, he gets the ulti though, but they just twitch over to the Kale. Twitch still goes down anyway. The Lantern comes in as well. Nice amount of shields. Shotgun keeps Gilius back, and this battle's going so well for H2K. Big damage down to the jungler. Jack to the back lines actually finds the kill though. 2-for-1 so far. Oh, Dwalin actually forced away. Maybe they can find just something, but no. 3-for-1 in this battle. H2K playing it right, flashing away with Odwamne.
And that just erupted out of nowhere. Zyze, he was standing around people as if they were his teammate.
Yeah.
I was like, that Twitch is extremely close to
enemy champions.
To enemy champions. Well, what's happening? They end up going 3-for-1 and getting a turret off of it. Just even more map pressure. They're going to be able to ward up this entire area and rotate down bottom and possibly get themselves another turret. Look at, he's so close to Yharnam, but Trashy comes out from the fog of war, immediately switches targets when the intervention comes on. And oh, Trashy gets out, but he goes back in. He got the Lantern, and Smitty finally gets his first kill of the game. And Odwamne ends up getting Gilius. They trade junglers there. There's a good Lantern by AOD. AOD is also a very, very good pickup.
Yeah.
New member of the team, very high kill participation, and he knows what to do on multiple champions. We've seen him on the Thresh both games. His hooks are on point, and so are his Lanterns. They're going for a Desperation Baron here from SKP, though. Shockwave is almost up.
Big damage comes through. Zyze losing health. They're going to stay for this one. They do pick up Baron Nashor. Now can SK Prime get away? Have they breathed life into this game?
Wow.
7,500 gold deficit, but Baron buff holds most of that back if they can farm it up and use these combat stats.
Yeah, it's an earlier Baron, too. They end up with about 32 bonus AP and AD as opposed to 40. So it's not at the maximum cap. So there's still an advantage here for H2K in combat stats. By about 3K.
Yeah. And remember that, of course, SKP has to buy from the 300 gold they all got from the Baron going down as well. So now, this is the test. Last time around, SKP got Baron, went back to gold parity, and didn't do much with it. This time around, actually, they're still behind pretty significantly. It's okay if SKP waits around and just says, go for late game, go for late game. This is a team with Twitch, Kale, and Jax. You cannot let this game go to 45 minutes without starving them.
Yeah.
This is a real risk for H2K right now. That Baron was big.
Right now in this meta, when you think about late game champions in top, middle, and AD carry positions, those are the three.
Those are the three.
Those are the exact three. And we see that Wata Fox, he's actually going to go for the Runan's Hurricane after he completes the Nashor's Tooth and Death Cap. Because he has the Berserker's Greaves. He's looking for the very, very quick Kale auto attack team fight shred. And they're trying to converge onto Odwamne and just clear this out.
Well, let's see. They are going to look for top lane right now.
Zyze is nowhere near this fight.
Ooh, Jax is still coming around as well. It's going to be a temporary 5-on-4 for this wave, and that's going to be enough for the top lane tier 2 turret to go down. This means an 8,000 gold lead, or 8.5, actually.
It's a sluggish response from SKP.
Yeah. Well, they didn't have any wards, unfortunately. As they left out, their wards, like their sight stones were empty and whatnot, so
now
no wards to watch
up.
The moves. This
That's
is
where the next fight is. SKP, they're going to have confidence, though. They have the Baron. They're going to want to fight this because basically it's now or never.
Yeah, this is a pretty big important point. No Lux Whisper for Yharnam means their AD carries are on parity right here. Dragon goes down really early, though. H2K on the way out. Can SKP make their way in? Dissonance going to stop this one. Hook not going to land. And nope, H2K.
They respect it.
Yeah, they did. But H2K, despite the Baron buff, going to SK Prime, pick up Dragon and pick up a tier 2 turret unafraid.
Yeah. Well, they're out-rotating them right now.
Absolutely.
Fight has not happened. Nobody's taken substantial amount of damage.
Yeah.
They're just going ahead and getting the objectives at the right time because the sluggish response from SKP, they're just about 2 seconds behind, which is more than enough.
definitely more than enough.
They're doing so much damage right now. We're going to see the minions still cleared away. No siege going to work here. That mid lane turret so low. But of course, you can't turret dive an Orianna and a Thresh when they're waiting for you there.
Yeah, the Thresh will get whoever you're after just out of the fight. Vi can lock somebody up. SKP just sitting on the Baron buff, letting it tick away, looking for the opportunity. But H2K, they're playing it right. They're not leaving any cracks, but they're still being aggressive. They're actually pulling away in gold.
Yeah.
While SKP have a Baron buff.
H2K was smartly aggressive.
Yes.
They found a turret with no opposition. They found a dragon with no opposition. Then they said, defend under turrets. With Baron buff, we are at parity. It's okay. But now look at this. Nice move, SKP identifying. Look, it's low. Just backdoor it. Great choice there. 3 turrets to 5. Not the farthest away, but still, Baron buff's ending, and still a 9,000 gold deficit.
And the power spikes here. Smitty is not even at 2 items in terms of offense. Very far removed from the Trinity Force. There's no Randuin's completed for Gilius. Whereas we already see Trashy going for his magic resistance.
3 items on Odwamna.
Yeah.
3 items on the AD carry Yharnam. Mid laners are close, but Fibivin's pulling away. Yeah, down the line. I mean, you can see like how that 9,000 gold lead manifests. Mm-hmm. You're seeing a completed item pretty much per roll on average. That's a big deal here. Zai's just been the farm he can. They know he's there. AOD gets a soul for Zai's hard work. That's, I didn't actually know you got souls from enemy champion kills.
Well, it's a monster.
Yeah, when an enemy kills a monster, still drops a soul.
Hmm. As long as you're in range, I guess.
Yeah, I actually didn't know that. So if you're Thresh and the enemy team gets Baron, toss your lantern and walk away. At least you get something for it.
Yeah. Get extra stats.
Get 0.75 ability power, 0.75 armor.
Nice.
Hashtag worth.
As he throws it out. Great timing.
It's like AOD's reading my mind from the future.
And now, it's really H2K. They have the advantage by 10K now. They have to feel it. They have to know it from the levels and the items. And now they're just looking for the fight. Baron's gone from SKP. It's up in 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm. This is the go signal.
Trying to make something off of Odwamna's push.
Now, well, H2K dive is a thing. They're powerful enough. They
could make
it work, but it is still risky, right?
You have to
if
swap
that dive
targets.
Fails, you've thrown the game away.
Odwamna has to get aggro, and you have to swap targets and get Fibevin to shockwave multiple people if you're going to pull the dive off. Because Wate Fox, he can just intervention somebody, but you have to swap targets appropriately.
Okay.
Zai's does not have power spikes,
Here's
and
the
they catch Smitty.
Hook onto Smitty. They're not really even clearing the waves away. Look at that. Yharnam brings that turret down to about half. Yeah. So within 3 waves, that turret falls.
Yep.
Within 3 waves, Baron comes back up.
Runan's completed for Wate Fox. He's going to try to wave clear these as much as he possibly can, but he'll put himself at risk of the shockwave because the range of Kale is not that large.
So how good can Fibivin get the ball up as well? Because you can amplify that range by getting the ball into a good spot. Right now it's in front of the turret as opposed to behind, so he's not threatening Zai's or Wate Fox. There's
if he
new
moves
wave.
Off to the right, he can get a little deeper.
He can. Right now he's not going to do that, though. Big damage comes through. Vi waiting around the wings, and SK Prime refuse to defend the getaway. No hook comes in, or no hook lands, I should say, and that means the turret. Now Baron in 40 seconds. H2K have not set up wards for it yet.
And I'm going to go ahead, clear out the middle lane, and leave Odwamna to split push. They may go for a Baron with a split push on the Shyvana.
Well, there's enough wards in that bottom side because they're besieging it. Odwamna's safe right here. He's actually been set up by the team to live in this area of the map. However, AOD's Sightstone nearly empty. Very few pink wards in inventory. Actually, none in inventory. H2K can't easily set up Baron right now without recalling and losing some time here. SK Prime have a short 5-on-4. There's actually no wards to teleport to right here. They actually couldn't get a Odwamna into the fight until they throw a lantern down for him. There's one ward just now.
There's also a ward in Fibevin's inventory.
Yeah, you're right. That was
we'll
there.
See what the call is. They actually send Smitty back.
That's a good choice.
So there's actually a flank opportunity right now from Odwamna if he teleports to a ward off on the side and comes in.
Well, he's going to look for it. There, moves off to the side. There we
go. Or he's
just
going
to
come straight down the lane.
They get a knock up on a trash. They got to be careful though. AOD loses a lot of health though. Twitch getting big damage down, but what the Fox gets the ulti down just barely. Zyze, he goes down though. He gets caught out and falls over. That's a 1-0 so far. Febivin in the back line is getting hit up by Smitty, but he can't find the kill. 2-0. What the Fox goes down the trashy. H2K crushed this team fight 4-0.
And they're just going to go straight down the middle. Just neglect Baron, get it on the retreat. The 40-second death timers now for SKP. It's more than enough for them to just face tank a turret and get an inhibitor too.
Wow, this is going to be a whole lot for them. I mean, I wouldn't even be surprised to see a surrender from SK Prime at this point because so much is going to be picked up there. But it's going to be the turret so far. As you say, inhibitor going to be likely afterwards, and they've already even picked towards Baron. So those will be the three. Then the safe recall unless Gilius goes for a miracle steal.
13k gold advantage inhibitor. Super minions will be pouring down into their base. The Baron is live. They're going to pick it up for themselves. And watch Zyze's positioning here around AOD.
That hooked
in,
into
displaced off to the side, and he has to flash, but he flashes right into the wall of the box to get killed. The shockwave and the hook displacement puts the AD carry, the priority target for H2K, in the worst position possible for SKP.
Yeah. AOD won that fight for them by hooking that one.
Mm-hmm.
That
yeah, he's won a lot of fights for them before they even started.
That's true. They've been 5v1s with a hook to lead it out. Just gotta say, it's great playing with these guys.
Wonderful pickup.
Absolutely.
For he's H2K. Been, both Trashy awesome. And AOD have been coming up big in this series.
This is a good team.
Yeah. I was hesitant at first because I'm like, they lost Ko. They lost Voidal.
Sure.
Don't know if H2K are going to be at the same form, but they are proving that they're definitely on point, they're definitely in form, and they're a little bit better than they were before.
Yeah.
They were. I mean, how do you get better? They were number one in the Challenger Series last time. Mm-hmm. They could go all the way from what I've been seeing today.
I mean, think about it, right? Like, think about last Challenger Series throughout spring, really. The big rivalry, for the most part, was C9E versus NIP. Ko went over to NIP, that big rival. Now, the Challenger Series 1 finals, the first place match, is going to be played at that London Roadshow in a couple of weeks, live in person, and you're going to have basically H2K saying, shouldn't left the team. If they go all the way. I'm just saying, right?
There's like, a lot of people.
Yes, there's a match in front of them. They play Leblin. If they win this match, and to be honest, they're looking really good here, right? They win this match, they play Leblin Shore in the semifinals. They win the semifinals, onto the finals they go. NIP, of course, is going to fight Gamers too, but like this rivalry up inside the bracket.
They're definitely favorites to meet. Mm-hmm. In the finals,
favorites
but the semifinals, there's always upsets. There's, you know,
absolutely.
Best of three, anything can happen. Right now, anything can happen right now. Gilius, he's going straight in.
Jumping on him, but down he goes right away. 5-on-4 to start the fight out. They find Twitch on the side as well. Watt the Fox in the middle of the enemy team. Intervention not going to be enough. There's 4 kills, make it 5. AOD tanks the turret just for good measure. Gets out with the shield, and now this is going to surely be the game. That's going to be the turret going down. Looks like Surrender going to follow up with this one. 34-minute game, and H2K make it 2-0 convincingly. What an exceptionally strong team.
They went 23-3 in kills, played it perfectly with their new members. Trashy, behind at the start, comes out with level 6 first, ganks, sets that lane ahead, continues the snowball. Then AOD, before team fights even start, they're over because of the perfect engage he created for his team.
Yeah. I gotta say, Trashy to me is the story of that game. I mean, I loved AOD's hooks, I'm not gonna lie, he was good as well, but the fact that Trashy was in the right place at the right time every single time, the number of times he turned around the Jax vs. Shyvana matchup, he read the gank, knew to be there. Like, the fact that Smitty went 1-7-0 wasn't entirely his fault.
No.
Most junglers wouldn't turn every single one of those kills around, and you get one of them the lane snowballs. So I gotta say, impressive stuff by Trashy. He was freaking awesome. And H2K look real good.
And they look really, really good right now. And other Challenger teams could be watching this. They're going to be a little afraid of H2K. They're going to be a little afraid of NIP. See who they bring in for those new positions that they have open. And, man, I'm really excited because we actually have all of the brackets locked in for the semifinals at this point in time. SKP, they looked good in the round of 20 and the round of 10. But they're really going to be tested today by a top-level team.
Yes.
By definitely one of the top four, as we can see, because they're in the semifinals. And they have had a track record of success. You know, Cloud9 Eclipse always had that target on their back. We said it before. People have been chasing after them, being like, can we beat C9E? Can we beat NIP? These are the challenger teams to beat because they will most likely be up there competing for those top spots.
Yeah.
Is there a team out there that can upset them? The answer is SKP cannot.
No.
Can Lublin Shore?
I don't know. It's going to be the interesting question. I mean, Lublin Shore's new roster looks good. They look pretty sharp. That's going to be a fun match next week. Yeah. Now, guys, after today's matchup, let's take a look now at the bracket. The semifinals are now locked in. Next week, June 12th, Alex Zitch and Ninjas in Pajamas will take on Ocelot and Gamers 2 for the chance to compete in the Series 1 finals in London.
And on the other semifinal match, it is on June 13th. It'll feature Lublin Shore and tonight's champions, H2K Gaming.
That's going to be fun. But before all that, there's more LCS action on the way tomorrow when the North American LCS Summer Week 3 gets underway. Team Sulamid takes on LMQ, and then Evil Geniuses goes up against Cloud9.
Then Team Dignitas battles CounterLogic Gaming, and Complexity takes on Team Curse. It all starts at 9 p.m. Central European Summer Time, 12 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time.
And then the North American Challenger quarterfinals wrap up when the new Team Coast goes up against Team Green Forest. Now, with that, we've reached the end of our time together tonight. But before we go, I want to say thanks again to our friends at Coca-Cola. And now for myself, Zyrene, the entire Life Broadcast crew, thanks for watching. Good night. GG.